My name is Pheladi and welcome to Brown Innovative Cityscapes, a podcast that rewinds, reimagines, and recognizes the unlocked potential stored in the self-help and creative strategies present in African cityscapes. Greetings and welcome to the very last episode of Brown Innovated Cityscapes. So on this episode, I'll be discussing my takeaways from the whole experience of having a podcast and the lessons that I learned. When I was embarking on this journey of starting a podcast, I had not imagined that I would have learned so much. Firstly, my perceptions about colonialism and the impact that it had on African cities have changed tremendously. I had imagined that if colonialism had not occurred, the architecture and the social structures and the economic structures of Africa would have stayed the same and they would have not evolved. So in an interview with Professor Phil Harrison, I got to see the importance of not being narrow-minded. I got to see the importance of not romanticizing on the concept of African cities. So I got to sort of open my mind and think about how everything changes and think about how nothing is static. I've learned so much from this podcast to a sense where I feel like I also want to broaden my knowledge, because I came into this interview, or rather into this podcast, thinking that I know pretty much enough, but only to find out that I only know a little. Lesson two is that all of the things that I was imagining, or rather all the things that I was thinking about, were sort of based on speculation. No one knows how Africa would have been now if colonialism had not occurred. No one is sure of what African cities would have been like if colonialism had not occurred. Professor Harrison mentioned that chances are that there might have been a lot of tribalism going on. Professor Harrison also mentioned that, however, that they would have modernized and grew in a different direction than they are now. So, I learned a lot. And again, the importance of being open-minded was truly highlighted in this podcast. The historical architectural styles also might be beneficial in future, since we're seeing strides of being sustainable. So Professor Harrison also mentioned that we never know, maybe things might change to the old architectural style being considered as part of the building structures that will not be harmful to the environment. Also got to learn a lot about the revolutions that happened in the three countries that I looked into, and also got to see the role of social media in fueling and in informing people about these revolutions. Without social media, we would not know about the Black Lives Matter movement, SARS movement, Eswatini revolution. I also got to see that being in Africa does not necessarily mean that brown people will not be subject to any form of injustices. Brown people also inflict injustices upon other brown people. And in Africa, in this case, it's not a race issue, but it's rather a systematic issue. Going forward, I am pleased and excited about the future, because I'm seeing that the youth is now taking initiative and is fighting against whatever sort of injustices in securing a better future for themselves and for their families. Thank you again for embarking on this journey with me. Until next time.
Thank you for being in tune until the end of the podcast. I hope you learned something from it. Until next time.